Hello and welcome to a whole new episode of the Race to the White House. Joe Biden has 51% registered voters backing him in a new CNN poll, while 46% say they prefer Trump. So, is all well in Biden's camp? Here's a check-in. CNN poll, more than 55% of women and 69% of people of color choose Biden over Trump, while Biden outpaces Trump among voters over the age of 45 by a 6-point lead. That's good news if you're a Biden supporter, but there are major problems. He is currently trailing Trump on several key issues and in key battleground states. 54% of those surveyed trust Trump to handle the economy better compared to 42% who prefer Biden. But Biden is trusted more to handle a response to the coronavirus outbreak, 51% preferring him to 45% who prefer Trump. He's also trusted more to take care of healthcare. He also polls better than Trump in categories like uniting the country, being honest, having empathy, and in governance. People also trust Biden to handle a crisis better than Trump, 51% to Biden to 45% to Trump. So, it's unsurprising that some Democrats want him to be more visible, not only on television, but also on social media. There are two main reasons for this. One, Biden's campaign is very low-key, and second, he would have to deal with Trump's onslaught when the campaign picks up again. A New York Times report says that, and I quote, "He has yet to prove himself as a formidable nominee who can set the political and policy agenda for the Democrats and for the nation, and his campaign has so far not solved the unprecedented challenges of running for the White House from the seclusion of his home." The article says that Biden has not yet influenced the party's response to the coronavirus pandemic or taken on Trump in a strong manner. They want Biden to be more visible and take issues head-on. They make a case by taking Tara Reid's accusation as an example. Biden did not respond to these allegations after more than a month since they first came up, and his response prompted skepticism, which I told you about previously. They also want him to engage with youth voters and progressives so that they can win their votes. They also want him to address staffing issues. The center point of Biden's campaign is Trump's poor handling of the coronavirus pandemic, and some Democrats are worried that Biden is planning to let Trump self-implode, as per many media reports. Running a low-key campaign can backfire if he is unable to win new voters or expand his base of supporters. So far, he has held several virtual town halls, roundtables, and even started a podcast, but he is still not able to spur support. Now, his team is working on increasing his presence on social media, and the strategy has not done too well. Take his virtual meet in Tampa, Florida, for example. It had many problems. The video stream was glitchy and pixelated, the audio was choppy, and there were lengthy delays between speakers. At one point, the feed went dark for several minutes. Biden was also having some troubles, and he didn't know if the streaming had started. He asked, "Am I on?" Another challenge for Biden is his finances. Though he raised more than $60 million in April compared to Trump's $61 million in April, it is still nothing compared to Trump's huge campaign finances. Trump and the Republicans have an advantage of nearly $187 million, and his re-election team is planning to spend about $10 million on advertisements to target Biden. But Biden is making headway in one big aspect. He is trying to unite his fragmented party. He is joining hands with Bernie Sanders and has created task forces to form policies for the party. He has recruited progressive congresswoman Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez to co-chair a task force on climate change, along with former Secretary of State John Kerry. Another progressive, Representative Parimala Jayapal, will serve on the task force focused on healthcare. Until the next week, stay tuned.